Welcome to all of you. I'm here with my new topic, and the topic is sensory quality parameters of sensory evaluation. So what quality parameters is required for sensory evaluation, and how we can conduct these parameters, how we can use these parameters for quality evaluation of particular product, right? So here I'm going to start with this topic. Okay, so now come to the outline. In outline there is introduction, then objective, and then sensory quality parameters, right? Here the assignment, then learning outcome and references. These are the outlines. Okay, then now come to the introduction part. In here this introduction, the physical, chemical, microbiological and sensory evaluation are the main procedures to examine food for their quality attributes. Okay, here these physical means the physical properties, like external property that we can analyze without adding any chemicals. So suppose we have we are going to analyze some flour. So firstly we have to analyze their physical property, like is this particle size is required, is this particle size suitable or not, and have the particular water absorption capacity or not, have the particular bulk density or not, that is that will be required for the product processing, that further we will prepare the product. Okay, so we have to analyze the physical parameters. So there is some parameters, okay, physical, chemical, microbiological and sensory attributes. These four parameters fulfill the all requirement and fulfill the all quality attributes that is required for the any product quality attributes. For the any product that after these analysis, physical, chemical and microbial and sensory attributes, then we have we may launch the product in the market in for consumers for selling purpose, right? So if we will not fulfill the all requirement that is required, that standard for any product, whatever we want to launch there, whatever we want to launch in the market. Okay, so we have to analyze, we have to fulfill the all quality attributes, like physical quality means we are going to prepare the flour, so we have to analyze the kernel properties, like length, width, dia and bulk density, true density, 1000 kernel weight. Okay, and then when we will prepare the that flour, so we have to analyze these flour property, like physical property of flour means bulk density, true density, water absorption capacity, oil absorption capacity. Okay, so here the different here these all parameters is depend on the food product, that what parameters is suitable for particular product. Okay, so we have to analyze these we can call these properties like physical property. So these all parameters come under the physical property, bulk density, true density and water absorption capacity, oil absorption capacity, length, width, dia, 1000 kernel weight. Okay, and in the case of rice, then cooking quality, we will we have to analyze the cooking quality of rice. So size elongation and solubility and soiling parameters, okay, cooking time, all these are also come under the physical property. So these all parameters will depend that what types of product and what product we are going to launch in the market. So we have to fulfill the all requirement, all the parameters. Then now moving to the chemical parameters. So here the in chemical parameters, basically if anyone told you that analyze the chemical properties of the product, so you have to analyze only five basic properties. First, moisture. Second, ash, crude ash. Then third is protein. Then fourth will be fat, and fifth will be carbohydrate. These five basic parameters come under the chemical properties only. Chemical properties, basic chemical analysis. Okay, then anyone told you that analyze the physicochemical and phytochemical property, then you have to analyze all property, all these attributes, quality attributes, all types of quality attributes that come under the physicochemical and phytochemical property. Okay, so here in physicochemical property, you can analyze these moisture, then acidity, ash, and protein, fat, fiber, and carbohydrate. Okay, these all property will come under the physicochemical properties. Sugar content, due to sugar and total sugar, all. Okay, then phytochemical. What is phytochemical? That these phytochemical is depends on the plant content that is found in the particular nature properties, means plant content phytochemical. So these phytochemical properties, in the analysis of phytochemical, some properties come under the phytochemical analysis, like antioxidant, ascorbic acid, lycopene, all types of pigment analysis. Okay, then anthocyanin and phenol content, carotenoid, beta carotene, all these pigments and phytochemical, all these will come under the phytochemical analysis. Okay, then physicochemical and phytochemical analysis will come under the chemical properties. Okay, so you have to analyze both physicochemical and phytochemical analysis. Then moving to the microbial analysis, so in food product, lots of the microbial analysis we can analyze. Then specific standard analysis should be analyzed. SPC, yeast mold, and E. coli have to be analyzed, have to be conducted in most of the product. If you have a powder and if you have intermediate food products, so you have to analyze these parameters, like SPC, total plate count, and standard plate count. These are the same, and then yeast mold growth, and E. coli. You have to analyze these some standard parameters will come under the these microbial analysis. Okay, then now moving to the sensory evaluation. These are the main factor. Without sensory evaluation, these three factors is not required. If consumer did not accept the product, then no need and not play an important role all these properties. This is the important, right? But without sensory attributes, because consumers firstly they will accept the product on the basis of sense evaluation. If taste is not good, color is not good, then your product will not accepted by the consumers. Okay, so you have to analyze the product on that basis, on sensory evaluation basis. means firstly you have to conduct the sensory properties, and then you have to select the product on the basis of sensory evaluation, then improve the product in their quality basis but don't do not modified the taste without modifying the sensory evaluation property. You have to improve their product on the basis of quality and chemical and microbial analysis. Firstly, you have to focus on the sensory attributes. Okay, so these four will come to all properties, and will for if your product will pass the all these properties, then your product will come into the market phase, will come to for the launching purpose. Okay, here the various quality parameters are involved in the process of sensory evaluation. Here in sensory evaluation, various quality parameters will involve, like namely color, odor, flavor, texture and sound. These are the sensory quality parameters. These have to be written on the scoring card. Okay, these basic parameters: color, odor, flavor, texture and sound. These attributes are helpful in determining the quality of the product by the consumers. Okay, so all these parameters will help. If we will write these all parameters, then we can analyze what particular property is accepted by the consumers, mostly accepted by the consumers. We can easily determine the quality of the product on the basis of consumer acceptance. Okay, for a product, sensory evaluation play very important role for the following reasons. Here, yes, this sensory evaluation play a very important role in the production label, in commercial label, and before launching in the market, we have to analyze the sensory evaluation on the basis of particular trained panel, semi-trained panel, and consumer panels, like untrained panel. Okay, so these regions play an important role for the sensory evaluation of any product. What reasons, what consumers like and why? Yes, you should have the knowledge about the consumer acceptance and rejection. You should know about what types of can accept it by the consumer, and how we have to prepare the product so that that product will accept it by the consumers easily, and why is this product is acceptable. Means whenever we will prepare the product, so during evaluation we have to put the reference sample, right? So during evaluation, these reference sample these reference sample on the basis of reference sample, sensory panels analyze the new product and describe that, is this product accepted by the consumer, is this product will accept by the consumers or not. Because with these reference sample, these reference because these reference sample have to be accepted. Means these reference sample have been accepted by the consumers and have the particular selling place. Okay, so we have to focus on that base, that these reference sample and your sample have what number of difference values. Okay, second point is improve testing methodology. Then you have to improve your methodology. Means suppose we are analyzing the product and we have some product like we have two product like some semi solid product and second one is powder product, and we are going to analyze the moisture content. So what product have to take and what amount, how much amount. If product have higher moisture content, so we have to take the minimum amount, and if the product have less moisture content, then we have to take the more sample in compared to that higher moisture content sample. So on the basis of sample, we have to improve their methodology for any analysis purpose. Okay, so that we can analyze the product easily, we can discuss and describe the product easily. Okay, third point is ensure a cost efficient new product. Ensure a cost efficient new product means we have to ensure that your product have the particular cost value or not. Means suppose your product price is 2 rupees expensive in compared to control sample, because your processing is good and your packaging is better, but on the basis of these 2 rupees difference, your product will not accepted by the consumers, because they don't want your packaging material and processing. They just want your product, so they can easily compare the product on the basis of cost efficient. So you have to focus on that base also. You have to focus that your product should not have the higher cost value. Okay, should not have the costly, should not have the that much cost value, so that your product did not accept it on the basis of cost only. Okay, these are the main introduction, and now come to the objective part. Here is the main three objective: to understand the various quality parameters associated with sensory evaluation. Various quality parameter, what types of quality parameters is analyzing, and how we can analyze the product, and to understand the role of 5 senses in sensory evaluation. What is the all 5 senses, how these senses will play the all sense evaluation parameters. And third one is to understand consumer priority. Yes, this third one is to understand the priority, what product is accepted by the consumers. Okay, so these are the 3 main objective of this particular topic. Here then moving to the sensory quality parameters. Here is the sensory quality parameters. The sensory attributes of any food are which parameters is used will be used for sensory attributes, for analysis of sensory parameters. There is the four basic parameters like appearance, color, aroma and fragrance, and consistency and texture, and last one is flavor, means aromatic, chemical, feeling, taste. Okay, so first of all, appearance. In these appearance, here's sight. This appearance will come under the sight, and during appearance we can analyze the color of the product, texture of the product during sight. During appearance we can easily analyze is this product color is good or not, and means this look like a good, yeah, you can say that. We usually we just discuss these it's texture like a good, and we can try this product. Okay, so during appearance we can analyze the texture also, and size, right? And shining means is this color is bright or dull, or whatever we are going to try this product or not. Okay, and shape. So during one parameter we can analyze the lots of the parameters like color, texture, size, shape and shine. Okay, and on the basis of odor we can analyze the volatile flavor substances during odor, means aroma and fragrance. These odor, aroma and fragrance, during odor, aroma and fragrance we can analyze the what volatile compound is present in the product. Okay, these are the taste, and in taste I already told you the basic taste is four here. Salt, bitter and sweet and salt. Okay, so here is the four taste, and in there is taste, and then moving to the touch. Here the touch you can analyze during this touch, warmness, hot, cold, pain, stringency, texture and sensation. In sensation, here is the different sensations like cold, hot and pain. This is come under the touch. Okay, and this stringency will come under the taste. So you can analyze, you can check the property, most of the property in one parameters like sight, odor, taste. Okay, so now sound here. Okay, moving to the sound here, we can analyze the poppiness, cracking, okay, and pouring, fizziness or bubblingness. We can analyze during sound property. We can easily analyze all these property of the sound, like crunchy, crispy, that all come under the crackies. Okay, fizzy, is this product have gas or not, is product is carbonated or alcoholic. Okay, these come under the fizziness and bubbling. All these property can analyze in soundness, sound property. Okay, so these are the sensory quality parameters, and during this analysis we can analyze the lots of the property in one parameter like sight and odor and taste, touch and sound. We can easily analyze the lots of the property in one parameter only. Okay, and what is human sense? There is the senses may be described as a physiological perception of a stimuli, there are 5 senses in human beings. These are the human senses like sight, hearing, touch, taste and smell. I already told you these senses. Taste, touch and smell. During sight, we can analyze the color, texture and hardness, all these. No? During hearing, crunchy, crispy, all these properties we can analyze during hearing. And touch, hot, sensitive. No? Senses of the pressure, prescription, mostly in the skin and tongue. We can analyze the mostly these touch property. We can analyze you by skin or tongue. Cold or hot or astringent and hardness, texture. We can analyze during touching. And taste, is this product sweet, salt, savory or salty, bitterness, all these we can analyze during taste. And smell, what types of smell is present in this product, or odor, like smell means odor, volatile compound, what volatile compound is present in this product, we can analyze during odor. Okay, so this is the first lecture of this particular topic. Okay, so I will start the next topic, means next slide I will start in my second lecture. Okay, so if you have any query, so you can ask me, and I'm going to finish this product with this lecture, and this lecture is this is the first lecture, first part of this topic, particular topic, and I will start this second part from this. Okay, after this slide I will start my second part of the second lecture of this particular topic. Okay, thank you.